Hello, my name is Dr. Abrahamian, and in this channel, I mainly go over problems from math competitions. This one is problem one from the International Math Competition for University Students from 2025, which was held a couple of days ago. Let P be a polynomial with real coefficients. Suppose degree of P is at least 2. For every x in R, let L of x be the line tangent to the graph of P at point x comma p of x. Suppose that the degree of p is odd, show that the union of all of these lines is going to be R2. Does there exist a polynomial of even degree for which the equality holds? Okay, so let's kind of unpack and see what the problem is asking us to do. So let's say the degree of p of x is at least 2, and let's call that n. So that means that p of x is a x to the power of n plus and a bunch of other terms. So what does this tell us? Let's look at like a cubic polynomial. It tells us that if you look at this cubic polynomial and look at the line going through this point that is tangent to the graph of the function, and do that for every one of these points on the curve, then eventually, if you take one point on the plane, eventually there's going to be a line, a tangent line, going through that point. So let's write down the equation of the line going through this particular point. Let's just start calling this point x naught, p of x naught. So what is the slope of this line? The slope is the derivative, and then it also goes through the point x naught comma y naught. So we want to see when this line goes through the point a comma b. So the equation of the tangent line is going to be y minus, so we're going to use the point slope formula, p of x naught equals slope, which is p prime of x naught times x minus x naught. So this is the tangent line. So what does the problem tell us? It tells us that for every point a, b in R2, there is some x naught in R such that this line, the tangent line, goes through the point a comma b. What does that mean? It means if I plug in y equals b and x equals a, I do have the equality. So let's write it down like this. So what does it mean? It means for every a, b, this equation has a solution. So this is a polynomial equation. So for every a, b in R, 2, there is some x, I'm going to drop the subscript 0, such that b minus p of x minus p prime of x times a minus x naught equals 0. And let's go back and change this leading coefficient a naught, an, and then the constant term is a0. Okay, so we want to show that this has a solution for every a and b. So this is a polynomial. Let's figure out what the degree is. And by the way, this would have to be x. Let's figure out what the degree of this polynomial is. So this is b minus p of x. Of course, the degree here is n minus p prime of x times a. The degree here is n minus 1, and then plus x, p prime of x equals 0. So the degree here is n. So the degree of this whole thing could be less than n. Let's look at the leading coefficient and see what we get. So we get b minus, the leading coefficient here is an, x to the power of n plus dot 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 plus a0 minus p prime of x times a. Well, the degree here is n minus 1, so let's not worry about that for now. And here we get n an, x to the power of n minus 1 plus a1, and that is equal to 0. So let's see, figure out what the leading coefficient is. The leading coefficient is negative an from here, and then plus nan, which is n minus 1 times an. And of course, this is not 0. So what that means is that this polynomial that we found, b minus p of x minus p prime of x times a plus x p prime of x, is a polynomial of degree n. But if it has a, it is a polynomial of degree n, then if n is odd, it would always have a root, because we know that every polynomial of degree odd has a root. So that shows that A is true because the degree is odd. What about B? Well, because the degree is even, not every A and B gives you a solution. So in this case, n is even. Now, we can take this P of x plus a p prime of x minus x p prime of x equals b. So I set that equal to 0, and I want to see if that always has a solution. Well, we know that this is a polynomial of degree even. But if you have a polynomial of degree even, eventually it's either going to have a local minimum or a global, in fact, minimum or a global maximum. And this is a pretty well-known fact. So if the leading coefficient of this polynomial, let's call this polynomial maybe f of x, of this polynomial p of x plus a p prime of x minus x p prime of x, if the leading coefficient of this is positive, then f of x has an absolute minimum, which means there is some b such that f of x equals b has no real root. And that means for, in this case, for n even, it is impossible to cover the entire plane. And on the other hand, if leading coefficient is negative, then the exact same argument works because it has an absolute maximum. So there is some b, that if you take some b larger than the absolute maximum, there is some that b would not have a solution. And that brings me to the end of this video. So I will see you in the next video.